Hello and welcome back to my channel. I'm Ashley and this is The Rural Companion. In today's video, I'm going to do two things. First up, I'm going to give you a very quick and fast list of the benefits of ginger. And then the second part of this video, I'm going to take you into my kitchen and we are going to make two of our very favorite recipes involving ginger, and you are going to be blown away with how simple they are and how packed full of health benefits they are for you and your family. Okay, the first step, ginger is a powerhouse when it comes to boosting your immune system. Now, ginger is full of vitamins, specifically vitamin C, manganese, magnesium, copper, and potassium. All of these are going to help support your immune system, making you as healthy as possible, especially during the next coming months of cold, flu, and dare I say it, COVID season. The next benefit of ginger, and this is probably one that ginger is most well known for, is it soothes intestinal problems. Problems like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, things that go along with just your everyday stomach upsets, or all the way over to flu, stomach bug type symptoms. Ginger is fabulous for helping alleviate some of those stomach irritations or digestive issues. The next thing that ginger can do is help with oral health. Some of the tingly, numbing sensations from the potency of ginger, as well as its antibacterial properties and all of the vitamins that I mentioned in the number one, boosting your immune system, are great for your mouth. A fourth benefit to ginger is that it is great for your skin health. It is an anti-inflammatory as well as antioxidant rich, so it will help with various skin problems as well as scalp ailments. Fifth benefit to consuming ginger on a regular basis, and this one kind of goes back into the first one, is that it is very beneficial during the cold and flu season. Because of all of the above mentioned benefits to ginger, from the list of vitamins that we have to being anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, it is also antispasmodic, antiviral, and antifungal. And all of these and more are great during this time of year to help with everything from sore throats to coughs to viruses galore. I would recommend that you take a ginger supplement, a ginger tea, consume ginger in soups or stews, or just on a daily basis, figure out what you enjoy. Okay, so a few things about purchasing ginger. Of course, you want to make sure that you are purchasing from a good source. I typically buy ginger from either Azure Standard, our local Sprouts. Sometimes our Sam's Club will carry an organic ginger. And that's the next part, is I do always try to buy organic ginger. Now, if you can't find organic ginger, you definitely want to make sure that you peel all of the skin off. Now, this might be a bit of laziness on my part, but that's why I specifically buy organic ginger, so that all I need to do is clean it, and then I can grate or chop the ginger without peeling it. And because of the way that it grows, with all the knobs and the fingers coming off of it, it is really difficult to peel. Let us go into my kitchen now, and we are going to prepare two of our very favorite recipes. The first one is a ginger chai. This one is going to be like very similar to your seasonal chai that you can get in the fall months. It's going to be warm, kind of spicy, kind of sweet, a little creamy. This is a drink that you can take just as a preventative, or you can increase when you are in the midst of a virus. A second drink that we will be making is ginger lemon tea. Now this one is just going to be the spicy hot of the ginger, but then the light citrus fruity flavor from the lemon. Of course, you can sweeten it. This one is probably going to be more kid friendly because it's not as spicy. You get kind of more of the fruity, citrusy flavors from the lemon that definitely overpower the ginger. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. And we will see you next time right here on The Rural Companion. Goodbye.